This video is made possible by Skillshare. The first 500 people to click on the link in the description will get their first 2 months completely for free. So a few years ago, back in 2009, Stephen Hawking decided to throw a party near the University of Cambridge in the UK. The party happened on the 28th of June, but the catch was that Hawking only sent out invitations to the party after the party had already taken place. You see, this was a party for time travelers, and by only sending out invitations after the party had already taken place, the theory was that only people capable of time travel would know about it and show up. Unfortunately for Hawking, nobody ended up showing up to the party, at least to our knowledge. He partied alone that day, but to any potential time travelers that are watching this video, you can change that by going to these coordinates on June 28th, 2009 and paying him a visit. Hawking believed that his invitations to this party would last for thousands of years and hopefully encourage somebody in the far future to come back and visit. But this ultimately begs the question, is traveling to the past even possible in the first place? Regardless of how advanced technology might get, there are multiple convincing philosophical problems with traveling back in time. Imagine that all of a sudden you were given access to a fully functional time machine. Let's then say that the first thing that you decided to do with this new time machine was to go back in time to the 1890s, find a young Adolf Hitler, and kill him before he could start the Second World War and the Holocaust. This sounds noble, of course, but the problem with doing this is that you going back and removing Hitler from the universe versus timeline would stop all the horrible things that he would cause from happening, which would remove any reason for you to have traveled back in time to kill him in the first place. No knowledge of Hitler would exist in the future, and therefore no need for you to have gone back in time and erased him. In addition to that problem, the consequences of Hitler's existence are so monumental in our own timeline that they have probably influenced the births of every human currently alive on the planet in some way. So an assassin going back in time and eliminating him before he could set the chain of events into motion that probably led eventually to the assassin's birth doesn't make sense. The assassin never would have been born to have gone back in time to have carried out the assassination. This is actually known as the Hitler paradox. But an easier way to visualize this same problem is the grandfather paradox. Imagine that you were to go back into time and meet your grandfather before he met your grandmother. You kill your grandfather, but that would mean that you never would have been born to have gone back in time and kill your grandfather. But that means that your grandfather would still be alive, which means that you would still be alive and therefore capable of going back in time and killing him. This loop can go on forever, and that's the paradox. One more final paradox that can arise while traveling to the past is known as the bootstrap paradox. Imagine that you were to go back in time equipped with all the works that Shakespeare ever produced. You then meet Shakespeare himself before he produced any of these and you give them to him. Shakespeare then goes on to produce all of these works based off of the knowledge that you gave him. But where did all of the knowledge actually originate from? It wasn't Shakespeare, since he copied what you brought him, but it wasn't you either, since you just brought them back through time. Shakespeare's works would therefore have no origin point. They would have essentially come from nothing, which again, doesn't make sense. But there are some proposed solutions to these problems. Imagining that the technology existed to take you back in time, the Novikov self-consistency principle is one theoretical way that these problematic paradoxes could be avoided. The principle states that the probability of any event that would create a paradox or alter the past in any way in time travel is zero, which means that if you went back in time, it would be physically impossible for you to kill your grandfather, or to give Toyota the blueprint of the Corolla before they created it. If this principle is true though, it brings up some pretty unsettling questions surrounding human free will. Any time traveler to the past who tried to change the past would be prevented by a physical law from making that change, which means that in effect, the time traveler would not have free will. Everything the time traveler did in the past would be predetermined, but an extension of this principle that I like to think about for fun is the idea of a time police. Basically, a time traveler police force that is always present at all parts of history, but invisible to those of us who aren't time travelers. These time traveler police ensure that any other time travelers cannot possibly alter the timeline of what happened. That seems pretty far-fetched, but maybe it's also possible to go back in time and observe the past happening, but it's impossible to directly interact with anything that's going on. That would solve the problem of all these paradoxes, but so too would the alternate universe theory. This one basically assumes that if you went back in time and killed your grandfather, you would only be capable of killing your grandfather in an alternate universe where you were never born. You would still have been born in your own universe, but traveled into this new one to avoid the generation of a paradox from happening. But traveling to an alternate universe isn't really time travel, so this way of avoiding a paradox doesn't really count. To me, it seems like it's impossible to travel back in time without the risk of either creating some logical paradox or by restricting humanity's free will. Which means that even if technology somehow allows us to travel back into the past, we still probably couldn't, or maybe shouldn't, because of how badly we could destroy the universe and ourselves if we did. So yeah, time travel to the past is probably impossible. But time travel to the future, on the other hand, is a topic for another time. If all of this information makes you stay up at night worrying about time travel police or if free will is real or not, then you're not alone. But you may as well do something productive with all of that sleep you're not getting by heading over to Skillshare next. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 19,000 classes on anything from graphic design, web development, video game design, music, photography, and so much more. One of my favorite things about making videos like this one on YouTube is inspiring other people to go out and create their own videos. Animation can be a really difficult thing to learn at first, but my friends at Kurzgesagt have created an excellent tutorial on Skillshare that's taught by one of their senior motion graphic designers. There's thousands of students that have already taken this course, including me, and if there's another project you're wanting to start instead, I guarantee that Skillshare has a class to teach you how. You can teach yourself how to do pretty much anything, and a premium membership usually begins around $10 a month for unlimited access to all courses. But the good news is that the first 500 people to sign up by clicking this link in the description will get their first 2 months for free. Think about what project you've been dreaming of completing or starting, but aren't sure you have the skills to do it. Why shouldn't you start right now and sign up to Skillshare using the link below? You have nothing to lose and an important life skill to gain. Thanks for watching, don't forget to subscribe by clicking here, and I'll see you around next Friday for another brand new video then.